In this video, a viewer asked about corresponding doses between rosuvastatin, or generic Crestor, and pitavastatin, or generic Livalo. So I cover that, and then we go into some other statins. We just cover a summary on comparison of statin dosages. Then we talk about something that's interesting. It's called half-life of a drug. It shouldn't take long. The viewer was Annie Kate, 1914, 4 days ago. Dr. Brewer, I'm taking 2.5, two times a week of rosuvastatin. How much would I take of Livalo? Well, 1 milligram of Livalo is a very rough, equivalent to 2.5 Crestor generic. However, don't expect to take the Livalo two times a week, or especially once a week like some do rosuvastatin. Livalo's half-life is only 12 hours compared to 17 for rosuvastatin. I'll do a quick video on it. So here's a statin dose intensity and equivalency chart. Here we have the high-density statins, the moderate density, and here's how they define a high-density statin is something that lowers LDL equal to or greater than 50%. As I've told you before, I don't remember ever going there. Occasionally, I've had to do some moderate intensity statins, but the vast majority of the time, I'm really just looking at low intensity statins. And it's more for cardiovascular inflammation than it is for LDL. But then when you go over here, you see this column is rosuvastatin. This one is atorvastatin or Lipitor. Rosuvastatin is Crestor. Pitavastatin is Livalo. Then you've got some others as well, simvastatin, lovastatin, pravastatin, fluvastatin. So when you get down into the low intensities, 5 milligrams of rosuvastatin is the standard. These were way back in 04, so the prices have changed significantly. I'm going to skip over a Lipitor or atorvastatin for reasons that I've mentioned many, many times. I don't use it. So you come over and look at the corresponding dosage for pitavastatin, and you see it's 1 milligram. So again, 1 milligram is the lower dose or lower intensity pitavastatin or Livalo. Now, remember I mentioned half-life. What is half-life? Well, to a lot of people, it's an old computer game. I saw it once, but I never really played it. But that's not what this is. This is a half-life is often originally referred mostly to radioactivity. When something had a radioactivity of X and a half-life of Y, then X would be half depleted in Y time. Now that sounds kind of weird. Let's go down and look at this. It's basically the amount of time that it takes to for half of in drugs, we're talking about the amount of time for half of that drug to be excreted. So as you see, you don't tend to excrete a drug at a certain amount every time. It's based on concentration. An image here that helps see this. This is the concentration of the drug, and the half-life on this drug is 2 hours. So at 2 hours time, it's gone from 100 down to 50. At 4 hours time, it's gone from 50 down to 25. So this is another drug here at time zero, it is at 20, and 1 hour later, it's at 10. So again, hopefully that helps you understand what half-life is. Why does that matter? Well, here's why. You know, the half-life for Crestor is 17 hours. That's why you're able to take Crestor twice a week, three times a week, or even it's been documented that once a week Crestor actually does have a positive impact on cardiovascular inflammation. You won't be able to do that with something that's got a half-life much lower. So thank you very much for your interest.